All right, into the finals. I will play first. And we will, ooh, snap, keep this hand. My hand's quite good. I was hoping to play Shahar this round as he's also three on this event, but unfortunately he dodged me. So we'll have to settle for smashing this fine stranger. Right on time. Land, please. That's not a land. Our hand is obviously gas if we draw land. Yeah, jeez. Alright, well, land. Thank you. So I'm willing to trade my God's Willing and the tempo if he blocks. I'm just afraid of getting crushed in the air here. If I didn't have maybe this Edge Scorpion in my hand, I might not have attacked with the favorite hoplite. It's not worth risking the one damage to not be able to play my 3-3 this turn. Ew. That is what we did not want to see. Well, that's going to make racing a lot harder. Not to mention, it means that any trick now puts his. Oh, jeez, he's another thing. Okay, so much for Nessie Nass being able to block it. We do have the God's Willing in our hand, so we can just bounce this once at least. He's in there on three lands. He's at 18, so we have 8, 11, 12. Yikes. Actually, that's not so bad, because we can give his thing pro white and let it, give it pro white so we can't get tapped. I think I'm gonna send all three of these guys and I'm fine just trading my courser for a skirmisher. I need to save the God's Willing as the bridge to get to 8 to 7 mana so I can monstrous my asp. What I mean by that is obviously this turn I'm gonna have 6 mana. I need 7 to stabilize, so I'm gonna block asp, pro white it, and hopefully scry into the seventh land to go big, and then be able to hopefully stave off his Winged Seed Rider. Unfortunately, that 10 life is obviously huge. If he was at 8 here, we'd just be winning. We could just like attack. We could just attack with everyone, and he'd be in a really tough spot. He'd have to double block with both his guys. But it turns out 10 life is a big difference. All right, so he's gonna try to tap my Nessie Nasp here with his Skirmisher, but thankfully we may even have something like Dauntless Onslaught here. Or coordinate assault to target both. But he doesn't. Okay, so we're just gonna go ahead and. I'm just gonna block. And God's Willing, my guy. If he had a way to target, he would have targeted his skirmisher. Soldier Pantheon, not gonna cut it here. Need to find either my Ordeal of Heliod or a land really badly. Yuck. Okay. Well, that's pretty good. So he's at 10. Let's think. If we attack with everybody, he has to block the Asp. Right, because otherwise he's just taking lethal. So if he just blocks Asp, he has to block the Asp and then one other thing. And one of these two. So he'll have to chump the asp and then trade with the cursor. And he takes 5, 6, 7. I guess I actually wanted to draw a pump spell here. Pump spell is actually lethal. But then I die in the backswing to the fire breathing. So I guess I just play this land and hope he can't target a skirmisher. Right. Protect everybody, just chumps the Asp and trades the courser. He only takes 7, he goes to 1. Or he goes to 3. Oh, he's at 10, right. He's not at 8. Okay, so they're just attacking these two. I mean, probably just dead. I assume he's the way to target this, but maybe not. I mean, I guess I don't think he had one last turn, unless he would have tried to get me. So hopefully he just didn't draw one. Three mana. That's a good. I would say 3 mana is a good amount for me tapping. There's not a lot of targeted effects that cost only 3. Alright, so he's at 5. We really didn't want to draw that land. Alright, so Tromper's attacking for sure. Scorpion's attacking for sure. And Skygird will chump here. Yeah, just those two. We're gonna have to fade another targeted effect. It's possible we shouldn't have worried about that one point, actually. Oh, he's a bestow guy. Alright, we're just dead. Yep. Man, he had to have the 2-power flyer too, that's so gross. Or else it actually would not have been enough. Yeah, top card would have done it, man. Unfortunate. Alright, so he has a ton of heroic stuff. Probably want at least one of these. I think I like the white over the red, especially on the play. I actually don't like Mortal's Resolve as much here. I don't feel like we're going to be in spots where we're trading, we're going to be in spots where we're racing. This card's not great at racing.